This video was developed by the Tennessee Integrated Food Safety Center of Excellence. This video will provide an introduction to REDCap, common terminology, and an overview of navigating through REDCap. REDCap stands for Research Electronic Data Capture. It is used worldwide as a HIPAA secure web application for building and managing online surveys and databases. REDCap is compliant with multiple security standards regarding obtaining and maintaining electronic records, e-signatures, and research. Each instance of REDCap has its own server and administrator. The administrator is the gatekeeper of REDCap, overseeing and managing an organization's REDCap usage. The administrator is the acting expert and has access to many more functions and features than a typical end user. In short, the administrator ensures data integrity and retention by updating and maintaining servers and modules and approving or denying changes to the data while projects are in production. Understanding how to limit data access to only those who need it is of utmost importance for an administrator, so discretion is important when creating accounts or giving permissions. While REDCap provides some training resources, the administrator is available to answer questions and troubleshoot if additional help is needed. It is important to note that features and functionality available to end users depend on the installed software version, adopted support models, and regulatory governance at the individual partner institutions who install the licensed version of REDCap. Before logging into REDCap, contact the administrator for the site you need to access to obtain a username for logging into the facility server. When logging into REDCap, enter the username that the administrator made for you when they created your account. The first time you log in, you will be prompted to set your password. After logging in, you will see different tabs at the top of your screen that you can click on to navigate to different sections of REDCap. If you have already been given user rights to projects from the team lead, they will show up under the My Projects tab, which you will see as the first tab on the top of your screen. The next tabs are the Help and FAQ tab and Training Videos tab. These should be the first places you visit when you need help. The Send It tool allows you to send a secure file to any recipient by email, even if that recipient does not have a REDCap account. Let's move on to how to create a project. Your ability to create a project depends on your user rights in your organization's REDCap. You can request a new project from the REDCap administrator, or if you have correct permissions, you can create one yourself. Projects can be created using an established template or from scratch. For this video series, we will build a project for an outbreak investigation from scratch. Once the project is open, you will see the Project Setup tab is displayed. Note the different sections and table of contents on the left-hand menu, as well as the different tabs at the top. The project is designed within the Designer mode. Enter the Designer mode either by clicking the Designer button or the Online Designer button. When you enter the Designer mode, you will see the data collection instruments listed. The data collection instruments are used for building surveys. We will cover building forms and surveys more in depth in subsequent videos. A project is made up of instruments, which are also called forms. The instrument will be listed on this page under Instrument Name. Each instrument can be opened by clicking on its name and is made up of fields that each have their own variable name. You can navigate to the Data Dictionary and Codebook by using the tabs at the top of the screen or the links on the left-hand side. The Codebook and Data Dictionary are living documents that are updated with each project change and contain all instruments and variable names and details. The Codebook page within your project can also be printed as a read-only PDF that shows how the project is currently structured. This quick reference guide is useful for viewing the attributes of any given field in the project. All fields, variables, and instruments within the project can be found on this page. Many questions can be answered by viewing or searching the Codebook. Some examples include: what was the format of a specific question? How were specific variables named? If a question was asked as a rating scale, what does each rating mean? The data dictionary is a more detailed version of the codebook in a comma-delimited file format, or CSV. It includes details on how the project is set up, but it does not include any data that has been entered. The data dictionary file can be downloaded and edited offline to make mass changes all at once. The edited data dictionary can then be uploaded as a CSV file, and the changes will be committed after it is reviewed and accepted. Access a project's homepage by clicking the Project Home tab or the Project Home link. A general dashboard will display information about the project, including the users that currently have access to the project and its expiration date, if applicable. The project statistics provide a quick overview of the project's data, such as how many records it holds, when the most recent activity was, and how much space is needed for project documents. Upcoming calendar events are also listed here. This concludes the Introduction to REDCap video. More information will be presented in subsequent videos.